Hello friends, today we will discuss about critical examination phase of the method study. The outcome of the session will be you should be able to apply the knowledge and purpose and means in the critical examination to the problems. The content will be what is critical examination, what is the procedure for it, and what are primary questions and what are secondary questions. At the end of this, we will be able to apply these questions and then find out a better alternative method for the existing method of doing the job. Critical examination, each element of the work as presently being done and recorded on the chart is subjected to a systematic and progressive series of questions with the purpose of determining true reasons for which it is done. If you just recollect what are the various stages of the method study is select the job, then record the various facts. After selection and recording, the third stage is critical examination. Now, the meaning of critical examination is this particular stage will tell us what is being happening in the current situation and the current present method, what are the possible alternatives for the method, and this is a typically systematic way of going for the questions, and then definitely we will be able to arrive at a better and alternative method. Based on the reasons, improvements are found and adopted into a new method called a better method. The examination thus requires exhaustive collaboration with everyone whose contribution can prove useful, and also full use of available resources of technical information. What is the procedure for critical examination? The use of questioning technique reduces the possibility of missing any information which may be useful for the development of better method. It is always said that asking question is more difficult than giving right answer. If you ask a vague question, you are bound to get a vague answer. If you get a specific question, naturally you will get a specific answer. So based on the focus, based on the target of the method study, we should develop an attitude of asking the right questions at right time, and that should have a typical flow for the questions and a typical technique for the questions. There should be a procedure for this. A popular procedure for carrying out critical examination is using two sets of questions. The first set is generally called as primary question, and the second is called as secondary question. Primary questions are those questions where the answers to these show up the necessity of carrying out the work activity. What is the necessity? Is that work was really necessary? Is that activity is really necessary? And then you have to find out whether this is required or not. And then secondary question, which allows consideration to alternative methods of doing the activity. This is the most important part of the critical examination, where secondary questions asked in the right manner and observed very closely to the facts will definitely come with lot of alternatives for the present method. So primary, secondary questions together will help us to find out what are the alternative methods. Now, primary question. The first one, purpose. The need of carrying out the activity is challenged by the question, what is achieved? Is it necessary and why? To answer these questions, determine whether the particular activity will be included in the proposal of a new method for the process. For example, if a machining process is being carried out on any machine, for example lathe machine or CNC machine or VMC machine, and then we are supposed to make some method study on the machining process. After collecting the data, after analyzing with the various parts of recording techniques, when we come to the critical examination, the first and foremost question what will comes to in our mind is what is being done, and what is being done, why it is being done. Suppose the answer is machining is being done, why the machining is being done? Since the answer can be machining is done only to meet the drawing requirement, sometimes machining is unnecessarily done because foundry processes are unable to get the machined surface required. I have seen many such cases where there is no requirement of the machining process on the castings, but whereas practically it is done because the foundry is not capable of being producing the surface finish and the tolerance which is required. Many times in the machining process also we are confused with machining surface finish and tolerances. Sometimes the drawing suggests that better tolerance is required, machining surface may not be much important. Whereas in some other cases, surface finishes of high importance, tolerance may not be important. In both the cases, we are confused. Indirectly write what is being done, machining is being done. What is the accuracy involved and what is finish required in that is generally becomes a secondary consideration. Therefore, the primary question about the purpose is it will tell you what is being done and why it is being done. The means, the second question in the list is the means of carrying out the activity are challenged by the questions. How is it done and why that way only? After what is done and why is it done, the next two questions are how and why. How the machining is done. Now, machining is done sometimes since I got a machine which is available, I am using that machine for the utilization purpose and I am using that particular machine. In fact, the capability studies and the drawing requirement is not really calling for that such a high resource machine. Even I can do the job on a lathe machine, but whereas I don't have a lathe machine capacity, it is being used for roughing, and at the same time I see CNC machine being idle, so naturally I am tempted to load the job on the CNC machine. How it is done? It is done as per the process sheet. We are basically have to challenge it. And why that way only? Why CNC? Why lathe? Why drilling? So on and so forth. We able to find out the particular questions in that direction. We are getting the answers in similar manner. Definitely this particular stage of means, we should be able to answer how is it done and why it is done that way only. Once these two primary questions are finished, we are moving to the secondary question of the same two questions. The aim of the secondary question is to arrive at a suitable alternative to the presently used method. At the end of the secondary question, one must get various alternatives as an answer for the secondary questions. For example, if you take the same purpose, if the answer to the primary question is activity necessary, is convincingly yes, then alternatives to be achieved. The objective carrying out and the activity are considered by the question, what else can be done? For example, we have thought that machining is done. Why is it done? Is it done to achieve the requirement of the drawing? Now, if it is really necessary, we have to say the yes. In many cases, it may not be necessary. We can directly avoid the machining process itself. There is no question of alternatives. We can directly come to the conclusion that yes, it is not at all required. Probably, we can eliminate the entire machining process which was being carried out. If the answer says yes, yes, machining is required, then what else can be done? Whether the same machine is required, the same process is required, same tool is required, same speed feed required, whether the same sequence is necessary, whether the same operator and the skill level of the operator is necessary, and so on and so forth. What else could be done? We will have to have a lot of alternatives for what else can be done. For example, in a CNC machine, we can have, there can be some operations wherein, as I said, lathe machine may be sufficient, but we are using CNC because of some other considerations, or because of a stray instance where on some day we receive a stray complaint that the lathe machine is not capable, and as a result of that we are trying to shift it into the CNC machine. In fact, the answer would have been why the lathe machine is not giving the required accuracy. Probably maintenance of CNC of lathe machine can help us, and then we can shift the job from CNC to lathe machine once again. What else could be done? Definitely we will have a lot of alternatives for this particular situation. Means, all the alternative means to achieve the objective are considered by the question. How else could it be done? Matlab, when we are considering the various options, we need to have how else. How was done? That was the primary question. How else it can be done? That becomes the secondary question. In the purpose, what else could be done? Now, in the secondary question of the means, we are saying that how else it can be done. How else? That can refer to maybe in the tooling related jobs, maybe in the fixture related job, or maybe we can combine some other operations, we can eliminate the operations, we can reduce the time required for the particular process by way of finding out the better method with the help of a better means. The means may be related to the man, may be related to the machine, or may be related to the equipment or tooling and so on. It can also be in case of metrology, for example, we are checking a particular dimension. We are checking with the help of a vernier caliper or micrometer or a dial indicator, and since it is an age-old process, we are continuing it. How else can I measure? It can be possible with the help of a plain go gauge, snap gauge or ring gauge or a plug gauge, where it can definitely reduce the time. Since we have established the process, we definitely can think of this. Below, shows a sample sheet for whose critical examination is done. What is the achieved? Is it necessary? Yes, no. What else could be done? And in case of means, how is it done? Why it is done that way only? How else it can be done? So these are the possible summary of the purpose and means of the primary and secondary questions. Now we have to think of a situation where a manager has started to manufacture the job with the help of CNC machine. Initially the same job was used to be produced on the lathe machine. Just to get CNC machine engaged and whose drawing shows no dimensions are critical, and is this manager's decision right or wrong, or it can be improved? It is in a plain thing whether a CNC job is really necessary, the job is really calling for a CNC machine or not. Think on this. The answer obviously is no, manager decision is not correct. The best example for the means is query in the critical examination of the method. Definitely, initially the same job was done on a lathe machine, and since the company purchased a CNC, the manager shifted the job on the CNC machine with some additional other considerations. Okay, thank you.